Greetings from Icekeeper One. My name is Carrie, and recently we bought a new washer and dryer. And before the delivery guys will pick up the old washer and dryer, I need to prepare them for the pickup by removing the washer hoses, drain pipe, the dryer power cord, and the dryer vent pipe. This is our old Kenmore washer and dryer. The pair is 10 years old, and we bought them from the previous owner when we bought the house. Neither has worked very well since we bought them. The washer is a front-load model and has never done a very good job of cleaning our clothes. It also has a rubber seal in the door with a groove, and the groove catches moisture that begins to smell over time. It's been a weekly project since we've owned the washer to clean the groove to keep it from smelling. So no more front-loading washers for us. The dryer makes such a racket that I've taken a pillow and a sponge to wedge between the washer and the wall just to keep the dryer from making so much noise. In the past few days, the dryer has started squealing with what sounds to me like a bearing that is starting to go. To begin the removal of the old washer and dryer, I'll first unplug the power cord to the washer and pull the end of the drain hose out of the drain pipe. Next, I'll shut off the hot and cold water supply at the supply valves. On this setup, the cold water supply has a blue handle and the hot water supply has a red handle. With a pair of pliers, I'll loosen and remove the fittings on the supply valves by twisting them counterclockwise. When they're undone, I'll pull the washer out of the enclosure and undo the washer hoses from the back of the washer. Then with a pair of pliers, I'll squeeze the hose clamp on the drain hose to the washer, loosen the clamp, and slide it off the outlet stub. Then I'll pull the drain hose off the washer outlet. The washer is now ready for pickup, so next I'll start on the dryer. First I'll unplug the power cord, then I'll pull the dryer away from the wall to where I can get to the back panel. Next I'll take a nut driver and remove the screws in the cover plate for the power cord. Then I'll remove the cover plate and loosen the screws on the terminals to where I can remove the power cord. With the power cord removed, I'll move on to the dryer vent pipe. Where the vent pipe connects to the dryer, there are hose clamps that secure the pipe to the elbow and dryer outlet. I'll loosen the bolts on the clamps counterclockwise, then pull the fitting off the dryer outlet. Next, I'll go to where the flexible pipe connects to the vent pipe running outside and loosen the clamp. When the clamp is loose, I'll pull the flexible pipe off the vent pipe. The reason I'm removing this vent pipe is because it's been partially crushed in a couple of places and is full of lint. What I'll do is install a new vent pipe when I get the new dryer. That's all of the parts I need to remove, and after I pull the dryer out of the enclosure, I'll spend a bit of time cleaning up the enclosure so that it's ready for the new washer and dryer. The old washer and dryer are now ready for pickup, and that completes this video on how to remove the old washer and dryer. If you like this video, please click the thumbs up, and to see more of my do-it-yourself videos, visit my channel Icekeeper One on YouTube.